Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Classes for You. Today's video is about profit and loss, and in this video we will see how we can calculate profit and loss and also its percentage. So come back to our video, profit and loss. So friends, profit and loss is used in mathematics, okay, to determine the commodity, the price of commodity in the market. And also it is used for who are running a business to see whether they are getting profit or loss, okay. So based on this only, we will see some examples also how we can calculate. So see, every product has a cost price and selling price. So first we will say cost price and selling price. See friends, cost price, okay, means cost price means whatever you are purchasing, a product means purchasing, that is your cost price. If you are going to market and you want to buy something, okay, then what we can say, that is your cost price, means whatever the product you are purchasing, that is your cost price, and it is denoted by CP, okay, cost price. Next we will see selling price. Selling price means the product, if you want to sell to other person, or the shopkeeper want to sell the product, that is your selling price, and it is denoted by SP. Okay, cost price means CP and selling price means SP. Based on this only we will see how profit and loss depend. See, if suppose I'm purchasing 100 rupees pencil, okay, that is my CP. As I am purchasing 100 pencils, that is my CP. And if suppose I am giving to another person for rupees 120 pencil, 120, that is my SP. I am selling these pencils, okay, I am selling, say suppose 10 pencils I am buying 100 rupees, and I want to sell these pencils for rupees 120, as my CP is less than SP, that is equals to, see, as I purchased from 100 rupees, and I am selling these only, this much pencils only, to some other person to 120 rupees, in that case my profit is there, right? As I bought 100 rupees and I am selling 120 rupees, so in that case my profit is there, and profit says that SP minus CP. What it says? SP minus CP. Profit means selling price minus cost price. Now same way we can calculate for loss also. Yeah, loss. What it says, if suppose I am purchasing one pen, and its CP is, wait, I will calculate here, otherwise, in this side. Suppose I am purchasing a pen, and its CP is 120, okay, rupees 120, and I am selling this pen to some other person for rupees 100. In this case, what I am getting, SP is less than CP. Why? See, as I brought for 120 rupees, as I purchased that pen for 120 rupees and I am selling the similar pen for rupees 100, what happened? In that case, my loss is there, right? Loss is there. So, in this case, I can say loss is equals to CP minus SP, right? CP minus SP. So based on these only, we will see one example, okay, for profit and loss and also its percentage. then we will move to next topic, that is my mark price. Okay, see, suppose CP of a pen is rupees 120 and SP of a pen rupees 100, right? I'm taking same example only. So here what happened, my CP is greater than SP. So what happened, I'm purchasing a pen for rupees 120 and I'm selling that pen only 100 rupees. So there is my loss, right? So loss is equals to CP minus SP, that is equals to 120 minus 100 rupees, that is 20 rupees loss is there, right? 20 rupees. So if loss is there, so you can calculate loss percent also. What my loss percent says, you have to calculate, suppose if question is asking, you have to find out loss also and loss percentage, means how much percent you are getting loss, okay? So in that case, my loss percent says that loss upon CP into 100, right? So how much is my loss? 20. And how much is my CP? That is 120 into 100, right? 0, 0 get cancelled. So means how much? 200 by 12. So now you can cut out, cancel out. This is 100 and this becomes 6. So it become how much my percentage? 6 ones are 16 point. How much? Again 6. No, no, not 16. Wait, we can calculate here. 1, 6 6 36 again 6 6 percent, I will get right. Yeah, it was right only. So what I will get, how much I am getting loss percent? 16.6, right? My loss is 20 rupees, CP is 120, and formula says that loss upon CP into 100. So when these two get cancelled, 2 into 100 you will get 200, and what left? 12. So what I cancelled out with 2 hundreds and 2 sixes, when you divide these two you will get this much percent. Okay, so we will similarly, we can calculate for profit also. You can calculate for profit and you can also do profit percent. Profit percent means, say, if suppose my CP is 100 rupees and SP is rupees 120, okay, in that case my profit is, as here SP is greater than CP, so profit is 120 minus 100 means 20 rupees, right? 20 rupees. So profit percent means profit upon CP into 100. So your profit is 20 upon 120 into 100. Again you will get same, that is 16.66%, right? So in this way you can calculate your profit percent, loss percent, profit and loss. So we will next move towards your mark price and discount also. Okay, mark price, see friends, mark price means if you are purchasing a product, so say Maggie, okay, Maggie, its MRP is, say, suppose 50, okay, that is your mark price rate, okay, mark price. If Maggie, the mark price of this Maggie packet is rupees 50, okay, this is your mark price. I can say whenever you're going to shop, you always see that mark price, right? How much MRP is there, how much MRP for oil packet, like that. So that is your mark price. So if suppose there is 5% off, means 5% discount on this Maggie packet, So 5% of 50 rupees. First you need to calculate discount. How much discount you are getting on this product? 5% of 50 rupees. Why? Because my MRP is 50 only. So when these two get cancelled, 5 1s are 5 2s are, means 5 upon 2, what you will get? How much? 2.5 rupees, right? 2.5 rupees. Or you can say how much? 2.5 only. So this much discount you are getting on this product. So my final price will be, as my discount is, rupees 2.5. So I need to calculate SP, means the shopkeeper will sell that how much? 50 minus 2.5. Means 47.5 you will get, right? That Maggi packet will get 47.5. Why? See, what I am telling that, what I want to say, that MRP is rupees 50, right? And if suppose any discount is there on that product, that is say, let us take 5% off on that product. So 5%, first you need to calculate discount, how much discount you are getting. So 5%, 5% means 5 upon 100 of that product, whatever product I am taking, 50 rupees, okay. So how much I got? 2.5 rupees, discount I am getting 2.5 rupees. So your discount is 2.5 rupees, the shopkeeper will sell, means your MRP minus discount you will get this much, he will sell this much rupees to you and you need to pay this much amount, okay. We will see one more example. See, you went to market for purchasing shirt, okay, that cost rupees 1000 and discount is you are having discount, suppose whenever you are going for shopping, there always says 10% discount, right? 10% discount, like that. So we will see here, if that shirt is offering you 10% discount and you need to calculate SP, means how much the shopkeeper will sell to you, what amount you need to pay, okay. So in that case, what we need to do, first you need to calculate discount. This is discount percent, okay. 10% of this shirt means 10% of shirt 1000 rupees, so 00 get cancelled. So how much discount he is offering to you? 100 rupees. How much discount he is offering to you? 100 rupees. So easily you can calculate that you need to pay 1000 minus 100, means your MRP, whatever MRP is there, means this is MRP only, MRP minus your discount, that is you are getting 900 rupees you need to pay, right? So this topic is what I covered here, cost price, selling price, profit loss, profit percent, loss percent, and here also I covered that MRP means mark price, and also along with that discount. So whenever you are going for shopping, that always they offer your discount percent, right? 5%, 10%, so you can also calculate easily how that to take out, okay, first discount, then selling price. So please watch this video, share it, like it, and thank you.